Hey folks, welcome back to the Wild West Crypto Show. I'm Drew, and it is time for my Cowboy Logic segment. And folks, I'm going to do the segment today on negotiating from a position of weakness. Now, if you listen to that, just negotiating from a position of weakness, it doesn't sound good for the person who's in the weak point. You know, it's funny, as a kid, and we always did this around Christmas, and then when I raised my kids, they did it. We always played Monopoly. And everybody starts out with the same amount of money, and then you go around the board, and a lot of it's based on luck, but there's a lot of strategery, as George Bush would say, in there. And I'm not a huge fan of George Bush either, though. But strategery is where you go in and you try to kind of out-position, out-posture, out-negotiate the other people that you're playing with. And so it was funny to see me over the years, different strategies, ones that I used and playing with stuff. As you're going around Monopoly, and if you amass a lot of the land, but you leave yourself cash poor, and then all of a sudden you find where you're having to pay rent on other people's properties. I remember going in Monopoly, and I remember staying in jail at different times because I could at least survive another couple of rounds till I had to get out of jail, you know? And but if you're sitting there, you have your land rich, but you're property rich, but you're cash poor, and then all of a sudden you land on somebody's boardwalk or park place. Now you can go and you can, you know, take a loan out against your house, your properties and other things, try to pay it. But if you don't ever have enough money to kind of develop to the hotels and other things, conversely, if you happen to have done very well and you have a lot of land and then you go and you sell that stuff, you can end up with a pile of cash. But if you have no land, there's no way to really grow your cash because you're continually to pay rent all the way around the board. Now, as over the years, when my kids started, they started out playing Monopoly, but then they got the game Risk. And the Risk is global domination. A little bit more strategery and Risk in the things that you do. And it was a fun game. But the bottom line is the lessons that you learn, games like that, and I don't know about video games and other stuff, in the crypto space, with NFTs and cryptocurrencies and all that, we are seeing a lot of really interesting things happening. This thing that we talked about earlier today, the play-to-earn games and some of those things, they're actually going to teach some good life lessons and strategies and other things like I'm talking about. But folks, in the real world, I have to tell you, and it's incredible to me, I heard someone say, and it probably came from a movie, may have been Yellowstone. It's got to be one of my favorite shows, and we don't watch much TV, but that's something I can't miss, because if we could get back the laws of Yellowstone in this country and probably around the world, we'd probably all be all right, you know? But we don't have that. Today, the few who you would think were negotiating from a point of weakness, they cry. They cry about things being fair. And so they end up having a whole lot more power because especially the mainstream media and others go in. But I will tell you, they say in as you are dealing on the world stage, folks, you have to come from a position of power. One thing that Ronald Reagan did is when he went to Gorbachev and said, tear down this wall, when he created the space force or, you know, forget what he called it, he created the ability to go and shoot missiles down and stuff from space, and the entire world was afraid of it. And he said, listen, we're going to develop it. It's peace through strength, okay? He had the ability to go in and manage a whole lot of other things because he was strong. But folks, even when you're strong, you have to be careful because you can get spread too thin. We have seen the world dominating forces over the years, and whether it was the Romans or the Egyptians or the Chinese or the English, or the Americans, where we find ourselves, you get yourself spread so thin, and it's ultimately how they ended up taking over Germany, is they went there fighting wars on so many different fronts, although they were the global superpower at the time, they got so spread out that they didn't have the ability to go in and maintain all of it. And folks, I have to tell you, we find ourselves in a position today, it's crazy to me, that with the administration that has come in, that is really run by the weakest of the folks out there, and now we're seeing Fredo, we're seeing the, you know, we saw Governor Cuomo and his brother Fredo, and, you know, they hate all that stuff, but look at them, folks, they're lying to you about things, and if you believe them blindly, you need to, as Ronald Reagan said, check but verify, and here we are Our president of these United States was on the phone yesterday with our, really our number one adversary since World War II. I also believe China is right up there with them and they're colluding on things. But he's on the phone with him going, you better not do that or I'm going to wear you out, as my wife's brother-in-law says. And they don't have the power. We're in such a position of weakness today. The military largely doesn't support the man in office, although by decree they have to. But folks, we are laughed at by almost all the rest of the world because we no longer manage. We no longer have peace through strength. We are weak and we are giving up. Just last week they said, the U.S. is now afraid that Iran's going to go ahead with their nuclear missiles. Of course, there's no deterrent. It's like we're letting in the cities go on today. Strength is through law enforcement and punitive measures to the degree that no one is willing to break the rules. And we're giving all that away. So now the inmates are running the asylum. The thieves are sitting here running the streets because as soon as they get out, the ones that burned the Christmas tree in front of Fox Studios, guy goes out there, he's back on the street before they can finish the paperwork. Folks, we need to become strong again. With that comes responsibility. But if we continue to go and try to rule by weakness, it's a losing game, folks. Appreciate y'all always tuning in. Wildest Crypto Show. Be back here again next week.